let's talk about kind of how you can set short-term, medium-term, and long-term goals in an effective way, so that you don't just walk around with this long list of things that you want to do, long list of goals, but you never ever achieve them. So a way that I've devised for my own goals to break them down into short-term, medium-term, and long-term is, first of all, I've just made a list. So what you do to start with is you just make a list of every single goal that you have ever wanted to achieve. No matter how ridiculous it sounds, no matter how big it is, no matter how small, just make that list first of all. So you just put a long, long, long list of everything you've ever wanted to do on a piece of paper. That's your starting point. Once you've did that, you then select three or four different markers, different colours. And what you're going to do is you're going to identify goals that you want to complete within a month, goals that you would like to complete within 6 months, goals that you would like to do within a year, and goals that you would like to do within 5 years. So the importance of identifying the goals in terms of timescales is you've already then given yourself an opportunity to, from the list that you've put, to be really realistic. So if one of your goals is to live abroad, you're probably not going to put that in the category of I can achieve this in a month, you know. That might go into the 5 years, or you might even say a year. So what you're doing is you're helping your mind, but also using the colour coordination, you're having a visual image of the goals that you're going to set, when you're going to set them by, so short term, medium term, and long term, and you're selecting which goals will fit into each category. So in my short term goals, I may have things to do with my business. So one of my goals a long time ago, before I started making videos, was to start making videos, and that was in, I wanted to do that within a month. So I had to obviously prepare, plan what types of videos I'm going to do, set up my YouTube channel. So that has now been accomplished and I'm doing that. Another goal I have is to buy a house. Now I know that that's not going to be achievable within 6 months. I don't feel it is. So I've put that under my 12 months, but then I've also given myself 5 years. So with some goals, you can give yourself the option of putting them into two categories, which then means you're not going to feel like a failure if you don't achieve them within the scale that you've set. But really what you want to try and do is to be quite clear of when you want to achieve these goals by, and that's why you're doing the categories the way that I've suggested. So I hope you found this video useful. As I've said, goal setting is a major part of my life, and I also feel that it gives you purpose, it gives you direction, it means you have some level of control over where your life is going. So I hope you found this video useful, and I hope that's been a new idea for you really about how you